Hello and welcome to The Voice, a DBS Wealth Management Insights podcast. Each week we get to the heart of a hot topic in the financial markets. This week we head to Indonesia, where the agri-food industry has a clear message to send. Eat more chicken, please. Demand for chicken typically increases in May with the end of Ramadan. However, this year's demand turned out to be weak as the government imposed social distancing measures and dissuaded workers from returning to their hometowns to curb the spread of COVID-19. The pandemic also led to the closure of wet markets, restaurants and hotels, further dampening demand. In light of this, we expect the prices of day-old chicks and broilers to remain low in the second quarter before recovering in the later half of the year. There are also signs that oversupply conditions have returned. According to the Indonesian Poultry Farmers Association, the average broiler price dropped close to 30% from March to April. Meanwhile, the average price of day-old chicks declined almost 52% during the same period. Despite all that, the last week of May did bring a silver lining. Broiler prices recovered slightly as the festive season approached. The oversupply situation is likely to be short-lived, given the government's proactive stance to reduce price fluctuations. We expect demand to pick up after social distancing measures are lifted. Given that many are studying and working from home, consumers are cooking their own meals. There is also a growing trend towards the purchase of processed chicken in supermarkets instead of live birds from the wet markets. This change in consumer behavior might increase demand for processed chicken in the form of frozen foods. In addition, prices of corn and soybean meals have fallen on the back of a bumper harvest and a COVID-19 outbreak. This could translate to lower feed costs, which would support poultry companies' margins in the animal feed business. Poultry demand in Indonesia is also on a structurally positive trajectory, given its relatively young population and growing middle class. Chicken is seen as a major protein source in a largely Muslim society. If income or GDP growth heads higher, there is upside in terms of consumption per capita. But for now, we expect social distancing measures to end in the second quarter of this year and a return to normalcy in the third. As for the chickens, we expect demand for broilers to pick up gradually as wet markets and restaurants begin to operate again. For more details, do read the full report on Indonesia's poultry sector and where the opportunities lie. Thank you so much for tuning in to The Voice, a DBS Wealth Management Insights podcast. We hope these episodes provide deeper insight as to what's going on in the financial markets and how you can maximize your portfolio. For more insights into how we can help you pursue your financial goals, do contact your relationship manager or visit DBS Research linked in your email. Thanks again for joining us, and we'll catch you again on another episode of The Voice.